Atlantic Broadband Cable, in cooperation with the South Union Township Supervisors, presents the South Union Township Sports Network. Today, via tape delay from the Beaner Baseball Field here in Hutchinson, it's Little League Baseball time as the Yankees meet the Mariners. Hi, everybody. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay, and we welcome you aboard for today's game. South Union Township Sports Network coverage is brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband Cable, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV, including Gary Smith. Again, I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay, and we'll be back with the first pitch after these messages.
High energy costs eating away at your budget? Turn to the experts and call Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated at 724-438-5400 and ask for George or Mike. Let one of them tell you about Carrier's new green speed technology. Afraid of the cost of installing a geothermal system? Let Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated explain how green speed can help you achieve the same or similar results as geothermal without the same installation costs. Past history shows that the costs of heating and cooling your home are only going to continue to go up and up. Carrier's new green speed systems, when matched to your specific situation, will help you achieve substantial operational cost savings over conventional equipment. Green speed can give you the same or very similar results as geothermal in many different scenarios. Achieve SEER ratings of up to 20 with HSPF ratings of up to 12.5 for your home with green speed. Turn to the experts by calling Fayette Furnace Company at 724-438-5400 and asking for either George or Mike about giving you an estimate for combating the continuing high costs associated with heating and cooling your home.
We're back here in Hutchinson for Little League Baseball action. The Mariners taking on the Yankees. The Mariners to bat first here in the top half of the first inning. And leading off will be catcher Alex Busby. We'll set the Yankees defense first. In left field, Mike Tippett. In center, Blake Bell. And in right, Paxton Petronas. Around the horn, it's Tanner Hawk at third. Carson Broadwater at short. Tyler Hawk at second. The Hawks brothers, Tanner and Tyler. And Brett Lemanski on first. Jake Rakus on the mound and Patrick Kavanaugh catching for the Yankees. The Mariners to bat 11 here today. Again, Alex Busby leading things off. Evan Townsend batting second. Gayton Bercher batting third. Ben Diamond in the cleanup spot. Phillip Dennis batting fifth. Dominic Borelli batting sixth. Tyler Kalich batting seventh. Logan Miller batting eighth. Sam Scala batting ninth. And the two designated hitters, Nate Linderman batting 10th and Chris Powowar batting 11th. And we're set to go. Jake Rakus on the mound. Alex Busby in the batter's box. And the first pitch from Rakus to Busby is high for ball one. Our umpires here today, Vince Capozzi on the bases. And Rich Klink behind home plate. Nice to see both Rich and Vince out here today. Now the 1-0 on the way. That pitch right down the middle for a strike. 1-1. Rakus to Busby here in the top half of the first inning. The Mariners entering this game with a 3-4 record. The head coach is Brian Bercher. 1-1 pitch on the way, and this one aligned just foul down the first baseline. A nice cut there from Busby brings the count to 1-2. That ball didn't miss by much from staying fair down the first baseline. Busby will look for another rip like that. And Rakus is 1-2 now on the way. Another fastball. This one missing low and outside. Brings the count even at 2-2. Going to ask for a better night for Little League Baseball action. Game time temperature 78 degrees under partly sunny skies. 2-2 on the way. This one chopped foul on the far side by Busby. Count remains 2-2. The Yankees entering this game with a 5-1 record, excuse me. They played well so far this season, trying to keep it going here today. 2-2 pitch, breaking ball high. And we're full of 3-2. Now the payoff pitch, Rakus to Busby. It's on the way, fastball misses inside for ball four. So Alex Busby doing a nice job to draw a leadoff walk against Jake Rakus. And the Mariners in business here in the top half of the first inning with Evan Townsend coming to the plate. Townsend, the Mariners shortstop here today. Set to go, the bright orange bat. First pitch from Rakus, right down the pipe. Count it 0-1. Let's see how aggressive Busby is here on the bases. 0-1, another pitch right down the middle for a strike. 0-2. Now Rakus will wind and fire the 0-2. It's another fastball swing and a miss, strike three. So a nice bounce back there from Rakus, striking out Townsend on three pitches. And one away now in the top half of the first inning with Gayton Bercher coming to the plate. And Rakus' first pitch to Bercher, breaking ball, sent foul on the near side, counted 0-1. Bercher opposing Rakus on the mound today. The starting pitcher for the Mariners. Now Rakus is 0-1 here to Gayton Bercher. Fastball high. That one gets away from Patrick Kavanaugh. That will allow Alex Busby to get down to second. Now Busby, halfway between second and third, will jog back to the bag at second. And after that pitch, the count now even at 1-1, Rakus to Bercher. One here, sent foul. Cleared the fence area to one of the neighbor's yards behind us, sending the count to 1-2. with now Busby in scoring position and one out here in the top half of the first inning. 1-2 pitch on the way. Breaking ball misses high and inside. Evens the count at 2-2. Rakes to Bercher. And Bercher with a little bloop into right field. And that will score Alex Busby. And the Mariners strike first. So an RBI single to right for Gayton Bercher. Just over the head of Tyler Hawk into shallow right field. So Busby scoring the game's opening run. And the Mariners say thank you very much. And they're in business here in the top half of the first inning with Ben Diamond coming to the plate. And boy, did Rakes bring the heat there. Swing and a miss out of Diamond. Count at 0-1. Impressed with Rakes' speed here early on. 0-1 now to Diamond. Fastball high and inside. Hops away again from Kavanaugh. Down to second safely is Gayton Bercher. Count now even at 1-1. And the pitch from Rakes is inside. Count now at 2-1. Again, as we work with one out here in the top half of the first inning. And the Mariners leading the Yankees 1-0. The 2-1 pitch right down the pipe again. And the count's even at 2-2. Now Rake is looking for a second strikeout of the inning. Sent down Evan Townsend swinging earlier. The 2-2 here to Ben Diamond. Fastball low. Again, hops away from Kavanaugh, but a nice regain there from Patrick. Holding Gayton Bercher on second. But now the count full at 3-2. Rakes to Diamond. Now the payoff pitch on the way, and this one just tipped foul there by Diamond. Count remains at 3-2. And Diamond set to go again. Rakes will wind and fire. Fastball right down the middle for a strike. That sends down Diamond. Second strikeout of the inning for Jake Rakes, and now two away with Philip Dennis coming to the plate. Dennis, the fifth Mariner to bat here in the top half of the first inning. He's playing third base here today. Rakes' first pitch to Dennis. Swing and a miss, strike one. Count at 0-1. And Bercher has some pretty good speed out there at second base. 0-1 pitch, nice breaking ball, really fooled Dennis there. And the count at 0-2. And Rakes has done a nice job mixing up the pitches here in the top half of the first inning. And now look to finish off Dennis. The 0-2 on the way. Swing and a miss, strike three. So three strikeouts in the top half of the first inning for Jake Rakes. But the Mariners do pick up a run on Gayton Bercher's RBI single, driving in Alex Busby. It's 1-0 Mariners over the Yankees, heading to the bottom half of the first inning here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Creditors calling you day and night? Your debt overwhelms you? Although you may feel that you're in a hopeless situation, Zebley Mahalov & White can help. We're a full-service local bankruptcy firm that knows what a difficult time this is and what to do to help you get a fresh start. Call Zebley Mahalov & White today for a free consultation. Your hometown bankruptcy firm. Call us today.
Don't borrow more money until you talk to Zebley Mahalov & White.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
The Yankees coming to the plate here in the bottom half of the first inning. The Mariners leading 1-0. Tyler Hawk will lead things off for the Yankees. Carson Broadwater will bat second. Brett Lemanski batting third. Jake Rakus in the cleanup spot. Patrick Kavanaugh batting fifth. Tanner Hawk batting sixth. Paxton Petronas batting seventh. Mike Tippett batting eighth. And Blake Bell batting ninth. First pitch from Gayton Burcher to Tyler Hawk has popped up and right to the first baseman, Ben Diamond, who records the out. So one away here in the bottom half of the first inning. Defensively for the Mariners, it's Tyler Kalich out in left. Logan Miller in center, Dominic Borelli in right, around the horn, Philip Dennis at third, Evan Townsend at short, Sam Scala at second, Ben Diamond at first, Gayton Burcher on the mound, and Alex Busby catching today. And now at the plate and popping this one up is Carson Broadwater in foul territory, and the ball goes over the fence and out of play in the count at 0-1. Broadwater playing shortstop today for the Yankees. Son of one of the two Yankees coaches, Tom Broadwater. 0-1 pitch. That's a hard ground ball through on the left side past the outstretched glove of Evan Townsend. So a one-out single to left for Carson Broadwater. And the Yankees in business here in the bottom half of the first inning with Brett Lemanski coming to the plate. A lefty set to go. He has plenty of speed as well. He's playing first base today, facing Gayton Burcher here with Carson Broadwater on first. First pitch from Burcher to Lemanski is low, hops away there from the catcher Busby, and that allows Broadwater to get down to second. So just like that, Broadwater in scoring position. Now the 1-0 pitch in there for a strike. Evens the count at 1-1. Burcher to Lemanski. Burcher taking his time. Now we'll wind and fire the 1-1, and this ball, a little looper here to short and beating it out. Is Brett Lemanski advancing now down to third. Carson Broadwater had a little bit of an excuse me infield single from Brett Lemanski, but the Yankees will take it. Now runners on the corners. Still one out here in the inning. And Jake Rakus batting here from the cleanup spot. Now the Mariners have to buckle up defensively. First pitch here to Rakus right down the pipe for a strike, and running down to second is Brett Lemanski. So the Yankees showing they're going to play aggressive here early on. Now with Lemanski on second, Broadwater on third, an 0-1 count from Gayton Burcher to Jake Rakus, and the 0-1 pitch is hit here and through on the right side. That should score two runs. Rounding third and scoring is Lemanski. Broadwater already crossed the plate. It's a two RBI single to right for Jake Rakus as the Yankees take the lead, now up 2-1. You can see early on why this Yankees team enters this game with a 5-1 record on the season. Now Patrick Kavanaugh at the plate takes the first pitch inside from Gayton Burcher. Count at 1-0. And usually the teams that play aggressive here in the HARC Little League are the teams that are very successful. Now a 2-0 count, Burcher to Patrick Kavanaugh. Now the 2-0 pitch, fouled back by Kavanaugh. Count at 2-1. Tanner Hawk behind Patrick Kavanaugh, the Yankees batting order. Kavanaugh, the fifth Yankee to bat here in the bottom half of the first inning. Now Burcher's 2-1 here to Kavanaugh. It's a low, count now 3-1. With Jake Rakus on first, two already across here for the Yankees in the bottom half of the first inning.
Expect the strike. Take care of
him. Now this count certainly favoring Kavanaugh, 3-1. Burcher's pitch on the way, and it's in there for a strike. Kavanaugh thought he had ball four. Now the count full of 3-2. Kavanaugh must protect the plate. Pitch from Bercher. That one is low for ball four.
Eyes on, chin down. Eyes on, chin
so after Bercher retired, Tyler Hawk to start the inning. Four straight Yankees have reached, and now Tanner Hawk coming to the plate. The Yankees' third baseman. With runners on first and second, two runs already across. The Yankees up 2-1. Here in the bottom half of the first inning, and swinging at the first pitch is Hawk, and that's well over the fence and gone over the left center field wall. That was gone from the moment it left Tanner Hawk's bat. Home run to left center field, driving in three runs. And the lead now at 5-1. Now Paxton Petronas after the Tanner Hawk home run will come to the plate and try to keep it going here for the Yankees.
Here we go, Pax, your turn, Pax.
Dayton Birch will try to shake off that Hawk home run. And his first pitch here to Petronas is high for ball one. That was one of the better shots we've seen so far this season, that homer from Hawk. Swing and a miss, evens the count at 1-1. I'm not sure if that ball reached the lake out there. It's just short out there in left center field, but still a pretty good rip from Tanner Hawk. Maybe the grass being a little high out there kept the ball in play. Swing and a miss there from Petronas brings the count to 1-2. A couple of nice bounce back pitches there from Gayton Bercher. Now Bercher set with a 1-2 here to Paxton Petronas, and that's in there for strike three. First strikeout of the game for Bercher, now two away here in the bottom half of the first inning. They have retrieved that home run ball from Tanner Hawk. It might be a nice souvenir for him.
Okay, Big Mike, get mad, Big Mike. Aggressive.
Now Mike Tippett at the plate.
Mind, quick back.
Bercher's first pitch here to Tippett, swing and a miss, strike one. Count it 0-1. And the Yankees without any subs today, just batting nine.
This is a strike. Get to it and crush it.
Bercher's 0-1 to Tippett. In there for another strike. Count it 0-2.
This has any possibility of being a strike, get the bat. Put the bat on.
Now Bercher trying to finish off Mike Tippett. The Yankees left fielder, 0-2 pitch on the way. And that hits Tippett in the head. And he's okay. Lucky for him, it was a breaking ball. He'll shake that off. As one of his teammates said, way to use your head. He says, thank you very much. Takes first base. Goes through the concussion protocol, but he's okay. And now Blake Bell coming to the plate. First pitch from Bercher, and Bell pops this one up into left center field. Long run, unable to catch up with it there is Tyler Kalich. Bell's into second, tip it down to third. That's a double to left center field for Blake Bell. As the Yankees have batted around here in the bottom half of the first inning. Now Tyler Hawk, who led off the inning, popping up to Ben Diamond, will bat for the second time here in the bottom half of the first inning. First pitch from Bercher. This one again chopped, this time to second baseman Sam Scala, makes the throw over to first in time through Tyler Hawk, 4-3 for the third out of the inning. But the Yankees pick up five here in the bottom half of the first inning and lead the Mariners 5-1 here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Dominic Borelli, Tyler Kalich, and Logan Miller due up for the Mariners, batting from the 6, 7, and 8 positions in their batting order here in the top half of the second inning as the Mariners look for a bounce back, now trailing the Yankees 5-1. Jake Rake is still on the hill, and boy, does he bring the heat. Swing and a miss from Dominic Borelli, counted 0-1. Rake is one of the harder throwers we've seen in this HARC Little League in quite some time. 0-1 on the way. Another pitch right down the middle for a strike. Now 0-2 to Dominic Borelli. Borelli playing right field today for the Mariners. The 0-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. It's now four strikeouts in the game for Rakes. He's retired three straight, sent down Ben Diamond with a backwards K and Phillip Dennis with a strikeout to end the top half of the first. Now strikes out Borelli here to start the second. Now Tyler Kalich to the plate. Looks like he was showing bunt, pulls back, but the pitch in there for a strike. Counted 0-1. Really can't waste much time facing Jake Rakes. He works quickly and throws that fastball pretty hard. Swing and a miss there from Kalich. Counted 0-2. Rakes now looking for his fourth straight strikeout. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. So he sends down Kalich on three pitches. Now two away here in the top half of the second inning with Logan Miller coming to the plate. Miller playing center field today for the Mariners. First pitch from Rakes, breaking ball in there for a strike. That's the other side of Jake Rakes. Not only does he throw the fastball well, does a nice job mixing up the pitches as he did there on the first delivery to Logan Miller. Now the 0-1 brings the heat again, and this one sent foul off the inside of Miller's bat. And Rakes now looking for a rare inning of three strikeouts on nine pitches. Has an opportunity to accomplish that if he sends down Miller here. The 0-2 pitch on the way, breaking ball just high. So he'll have to throw at least pitch number 10 of the inning here to Logan Miller. 1-2 on the way, fastball high and inside, evens things up at 2-2. So Miller doing a nice job to hang in there on the Mariners side. 2-2 pitch. That ball is low below the knees. Count now full 3-2, so Miller's worked his way back into the count. Now the payoff pitch, Rakes to Miller. That one's down the middle for a strike, so Rakes had to work a little bit harder on Miller than he did on Kalich and Borelli, but still got the job done. It's now five straight strikeouts for Jake Rakes. It's a 1-2-3 top half of the second inning, and the Yankees lead still at 5-1 over the Mariners as we head to the bottom half of the second here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
High energy costs eating away at your budget? Turn to the experts and call Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated at 724-438-5400 and ask for George or Mike. Let one of them tell you about Carrier's new green speed technology. Afraid of the cost of installing a geothermal system? Let Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated explain how GreenSpeed can help you achieve the same or similar results as geothermal without the same installation costs. Past history shows that the costs of heating and cooling your home are only going to continue to go up and up. Carrier's new GreenSpeed systems, when matched to your specific situation, will help you achieve substantial operational cost savings over conventional equipment. GreenSpeed can give you the same or very similar results as geothermal in many different scenarios. Achieve SEER ratings of up to 20 with HSPF ratings of up to 12.5 for your home with GreenSpeed. Turn to the experts by calling Fayette Furnace Company at 724-438-5400 and asking for either George or Mike about giving you an estimate for combating the continuing high costs associated with heating and cooling your home.
Anemia occurs when one has a low number of blood cells and becomes weak, tired, and pale. Blood loss anemia warrants a careful exam of the digestive tract with traditional GI scopes and sometimes with pill scope technology. Doctors Ruthart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou offer the latest diagnostic testing for blood loss anemia. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Carson Broadwater, Brett Lemanski, and Jake Rakus do up for the Yankees here in the bottom half of the second inning. It's a 5-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. HARC Little League Baseball here on the South Union Township Sports Network. And Carson Broadwater, who got things started for the Yankees in the bottom half of the first inning with a single to left field, ended up scoring a run. Takes ball one here outside from Gayton Bercher. Now the 1-0 high, count now 2-0.
It's yours. No strikes, don't reach. It's yours.
Bercher's 2-0 now to Broadwater. That's right down the pipe for a strike. Count of 2-1. And Rich Klink calling the balls and strikes today. Vince Capozzi, the base umpire. 2-1 pitch outside. Heck, the check down at first. Rolling easy did not go around. Count now 3-1. And a pitch from Bercher. And a well-hit ball here to left. This one might go all the way back to the fence. Knocked down by Tyler Kalich, and on his way in a second with a stand-up double is Carson Broadwater. So Broadwater's second hit of the evening. He's now 2-for-2. And the Yankees with a runner in scoring position up 5-1 with Brett Lemanski coming to the plate. Lemanski an infield single and scored a run back in the first inning. First pitch here is low for ball one. Now Bercher's 1-0 to Lemanski. Swing and a miss from Brett. Evens the count at 1-1. Bercher doing a nice job, as we saw from Rakus earlier, to mix up the pitches there. Took a little bit off of that last one to Lemanski. Now the 1-1. Swing and a miss. Strike two. So Bercher now having Lemanski in a 1-2 hole here in the bottom half of the second inning. The 1-2 pitch, Lemanski popping this one up in foul territory. Philip Dennis made a run at it. The ball close to the fence, Dennis unable to make the grab, so the count remaining at 1-2. And a 1-2 again to Brett Lemanski. This one off the plate. Evens things up now at 2-2. Two-two pitch on the way, and this one popped up to left field. Tyler Kalich getting under it and making the grab. For the second out of the inning, or the first out of the inning, excuse me. And they actually made a defensive change there. They brought Nate Linderman into left field, so it was Linderman number one making that grab. Kalich got the start in left field, but that change made after the first inning. Now Jake Rakus at the plate.
Early in the count, make sure you can drive it. No strike. You're hitting him in a little box.
First pitch missed for ball one. Now the 1-0, and Rakus a hard hit ball here, but making the play. Evan Townsend throw over to first in time to retire Jake Rakus 6-3. Certainly close. Over at first base, but the out recorded, and now two away here in the bottom half of the second inning. Carson Broadwater getting down to third base on the throw. Now Patrick Kavanaugh coming to the plate. Kavanaugh walked and scored a run back in the first inning. First pitch from Bercher to Kavanaugh. Patrick sends it foul.
Eyes on it and drive.
Count it 0-1. Now the 0-1 pitch. And there for another strike. Make it 0-2. Gayton Bercher to Patrick Kavanaugh. Bercher looking for his second strikeout of the evening. 0-2 pitch here. And this one hits Kavanaugh. And Patrick will shake that one off. You could hear that. Right off of Patrick's ribs. It's a second Yankee that's been hit by Bercher. After Bercher hit Michael Tippett back in the first inning in the head on a breaking ball. Now runners on the corners and Tanner Hawk, who had a three-run home run to left field back in the first inning, again comes to the plate with two runners on, but will pop up the first pitch here in foul territory, and the ball will drop in between the catcher Alex Busby. Is a little slow in getting up, and the pitcher Gayton Bercher. So a little stoppage here as they'll check on Busby. Nice effort by both Bercher and Busby. And Busby might have landed awkwardly on the attempt. Now helped up. And he'll shake it off as well and seems okay. So after that foul ball, the count at 0-1 to Tanner Hawk. Bercher back on the hill. Busby still shaking off a little bit of the dirt behind home plate. Now he's set to go. Bercher's 0-1 pitch. Breaking ball sent foul. This one well over the fence and out of play. Count now at 0-2. Bercher to Hawk. It's a 5-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. The Yankees scoring all five of their runs in the bottom half of the first inning after the Mariners picked up a run in the top half of the first. 0-2 pitch here is low. Counting out 1-2 and jogging down to second uncontested is Patrick Kavanaugh.
Be big. You got this.
1-2 pitch now on the way, and this one chopped to short in the hole and gets past Evan Townsend. And this will score at least one, make it two runs for the Yankees. Coming across there, Carson Broadwater and Patrick Kavanaugh. That was a well-hit ball there from Tanner Hawk. We'll give him a single to left field and two RBIs. So Kavanaugh and Broadwater scoring. The lead now up to 7-1 for the Yankees over the Mariners. And now Paxton Petronas will come to the plate. Petronas, the sixth Yankee to bat here in the bottom half of the second inning. First pitch from Bercher in there for a strike. Bercher struck out Petronas back in the first inning. No one, breaking ball, swing and a miss, strike two. So Petronas in an 0-2 hole. Now the 0-2 pitch on the way, and that went off the plate. Count out 1-2. One-two pitch, high and outside.
That's part of being a hitter. Now don't fall asleep. This looks like a strike. You got to hit it.
So the count now even, 2-2. Bercher to Petronas. Bercher taking his time, and this pitch again high and outside. So we'll go full 3-2. Bercher to Petronas with two outs. Here in the bottom half of the second inning, and a 7-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupe. Nice to have you along with us for some HARC Little League Baseball tonight here on the South Union Township Sports Network. And that pitch outside for ball four. So Petronas working his way back into the count, drawing a walk. And now Michael Tippett, who was hit in the head back in the first inning, comes to the plate for the second time in this game. Bercher's first pitch here to Tippett. Swing and a miss, strike one out of Michael. Michael set to go again. 0-1 pitch. And there for a strike. Now Tippett must protect the plate. Oh, 2 pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. So Bercher retires Tippett, but the Yankees do pick up two runs here in the bottom half of the second inning. We'll head to the top half of the third with the Yankees leading the Mariners 7-1 here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Sit right down and you hear a tale of a fateful call. You better pay those bills right now or you take a mighty fall. He really didn't know what to do, so he turned to those who did. Sapley, Mahalov, and White, your bankruptcy crew. Your bankruptcy crew. So no matter how deep in debt you are, if your back's against the wall, Sapley, Mahalov, and White, just give them.
We're back here in Hopwood, a 7-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. Heading to the top half of the third inning. New pitcher for the Yankees, it's Tanner Houck. He switches positions with Jake Rakus. Houck was playing third base. Now Jake Rakus, who was on the mound and was stellar on the mound with six strikeouts through two innings. now playing third base. The Yankees' strategy probably at this point to save Rakes for another game down the road, up 7-1 here in the early innings. Now Sam Scala at the plate fouls off the first pitch from Tanner Houck. Count it 0-1. Now the 0-1 from Houck is high, evens the count at 1-1 here to Scala. It's Sam Scala, Nate Linderman, and Chris Pouwar due up for the Mariners here in the top half of the third. Swing and a miss there from Scala, count now at 1-2. Now the 1-2 pitch fouled back there by Scala. Count remains 1-2. Scala, Linderman, and Pouwar batting from the 9, 10, and 11 positions in the Mariners' batting order. And the Yankees only with 9 players here today. And there's strike 3. Nice effort from Scala. But he's retired on Tanner Houck's first strikeout of the game. And the Yankees have recorded each one of their outs here today via the strikeouts. 6 from Jake Rakes. Now Tanner Houck sending down Sam Scala. Now at the plate sending it foul is Nate Linderman. Linderman sending it low of our broadcast position. Down the first baseline. Count it 0-1. Now the 0-1 pitch right down the pipe for another strike. Count it 0-2, and Tanner Houck's gotten into his groove on the mound now for the Yankees. Now Houck's 0-2 here to Linderman, and Linderman a line drive to first, and losing it there is Brett Lemanski, and safe at first is Nate Linderman. So a well-hit ball there from Nate Linderman. Puts him on first base. And the Mariners in business, down 7-1 here in the top half of the third inning with Chris Pouwar coming to the plate. The first pitch misses outside, hops away there from the catcher Kavanaugh, throw down to second, not in time. Sliding into second base safely there is Linderman. Now he's in scoring position with one out here in the top half of the third. And a 1-0 count to Chris Pouwar. One-zero pitch, misses high and outside. Count now at 2-0. Nice crowd on hand here tonight in Hopwood. Taking in the nice late spring weather, and there's a line drive just hopping in front of Blake Bell out there in center field. So the Mariners getting production from deep in their batting order. Back-to-back singles from Linderman and Pouwar. Linderman now down to third. Runners on the corner, still one out. Here in the top half of the third inning, and the catcher, Alex Busby, batting from the leadoff position. Now coming to the plate. Busby drew a walk and scored the Mariners' lone run so far in this game, back in the top half of the first inning. Now he's set to go again and takes the first pitch high for ball one from Tanner Houck. Now the 1-0, again high, count now 2-0. Houck to Busby. And 2-0 is outside, and that will allow Pouwar to get down to second. Now Busby looking to draw his second walk of the evening. Had 3-0 here against Tanner Houck. The 3-0 pitch is down the pipe for a strike. Count now 3-1, wide throw there. A throw back to the pitcher, but the Mariners will hold station. Linderman at third and Pouwar at second. Count now 3-1, Houck to Busby. And the pitch on the way, and Busby will take ball 4 high. So the second walk that Alex Busby has been able to draw in this game puts him on first base and loads up the bases here for the Mariners with Evan Townsend coming to the plate. Still only one out here in the top half of the third. First pitch to Townsend, outside for ball one.
Lock in on the glove and hit it, man. Any base infield, step on a base.
Next pitch on the way, swing and a miss. One thing we've seen from both the Midget League games and the Little League games so far this season, you really can't count opponents out. In a sixth inning comeback a couple of nights ago in a Midget League game as that ball just goes foul down the first base line.
Infield, we're charging the ball.
I think that was, what, 12-1, Jerry, going to the bottom of the sixth the other night? Was it 12-1 the other night going to the bottom of the sixth? And game ended up going extra innings. Was decided in eight. So just because the score is 7-1 at this point of the game, you really can't count out the Mariners. Still a lot of baseball to play, only here in the top half of the third inning. Next pitch here to Townsend, and Townsend, a well-hit ball, but a line drive, that's going to be two. Gloved down by Broadwater and gets the out himself by stepping on the second base bag to double up Chris Pawowar. So the Yankees getting out of a jam. The Mariners, Evan Townsend hitting into a double play with the bases loaded to end the top half of the third inning. And we'll head to the bottom of the third with the score still. The Yankees 7 and the Mariners 1. You're on the South Union Township Sports Network.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
Heading now to the bottom half of the third inning, it's Blake Bell, Tyler Hawk, and Carson Broadwater due up for the Yankees, who lead the Mariners by a score of 7-1. We have a number of defensive changes for the Mariners, including a new pitcher as Bell swings and misses the first pitch from the new Mariners pitcher, Ben Diamond. So they count at 0-1. Now Diamond's 0-1 pitch, a breaking ball, misses low to even the count at 1-1. So Ben Diamond now pitching. Evan Townsend, who was at short, now playing first base, and Gayton Bercher, who was on the mound, your new shortstop for the Mariners. 1-1 pitch here from Diamond, misses low. Count now 2-1. Also changes in the outfield for the Mariners. Tyler Kalich now in right. Nate Linderman in center field, and I believe that's Chris Pawowar out there in left. 2-1 pitch, and there for another strike. Count now 2-2. Diamond to Blake Bell. Bell doubled to left center field in his first at-bat. Back in the bottom half of the first inning. Now the 2-2 pitch here, swing and a miss, strike three. So Diamond comes into the game to pitch for the Mariners, very effective, striking out Blake Bell to start this bottom half of the third inning. And now Tyler Ha coming to the plate looking for his first hit of the evening. This is third at bat. First pitch here from Diamond, swing and a miss from Hawk. Count at 0-1. Hawk flew out to then first baseman Ben Diamond back in the first inning in his first at bat, and then ended the inning as the Yankees sent 10 men to the plate, grounding out 4-3 to end the frame. That pitch missing outside. Count now even at 1-1. The Yankees plated five runs in that first inning, added another two in the bottom half of the second inning. Score remaining 7-1. 1-1 pitch in there for another strike. Count now 1-2.
Don't take strike three. If it looks like a strike, get on it. Turn and rip.
1-2 pitch. This one popped up. And it'll hit the fence. Not a play for foul ball. The count remains 1-2. The catcher, Alex Busby, was trying to get under that one to make a play on it, but the fence above the batter, Hawk, extended out a little bit, which didn't allow Busby to have a play on the ball. Diamonds 1-2 here again to Hawk is high to even the count at 2-2. Two-two pitch, breaking ball, and there for strike three. So Diamond comes into the game, records back-to-back strikeouts, sending down Blake Bell and Tyler Hawk, and now two away here in the bottom half of the third inning with Carson Broadwater coming to the plate. Broadwater 2-for-2 so far today, has also scored two runs for the Yankees. Trying to keep it going here at the plate. First pitch from Diamond, this one chopped right back to the pitcher. Diamond makes the throw over to first in time to Evan Townsend to retire Broadwater 1-3 for the third out of this bottom half of the third inning. It's a 1-2-3 inning, but the score is still the Yankees 7 and the Mariners 1 heading to the top half of the fourth here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Burcher, Ben Diamond, and Philip Dennis due up for the Mariners here in the top half of the fourth inning. Facing Tanner Hawk, who's starting his second inning on the mound for the Yankees, and this first pitch from Burcher popped up on the right side, goes over the fence and out of play for foul ball. Burcher drove in the Mariners' lone run so far today, an RBI single back in the first inning, driving in Alex Busby. Behind 0-1 here against Tanner Hawk. You have to be watching our game on Atlantic Broadband or Armstrong Cable. I'd like to remind you that all of our broadcasts are now available on YouTube as well. Just search South Union Television, and you'll find all of our broadcasts on the South Union Township Sports Network on YouTube to watch at your convenience on demand. 1-1 pitch. This one ripped foul on the left side. Got out 1-2, and that sent folks scattering down the third baseline. You're sleeping down the third baseline. That woke you up. Count now 1-2. This ball popped up. Carson Broadwater trying to get under it, and the ball hops into fair territory. Some miscommunication there in the infield between Tyler Hawk and Carson Broadwater. And Gayton Burcher aboard to start this top half of the fourth inning for the Mariners. Now at the plate, Ben Diamond takes the first pitch inside for ball one. Diamond struck out looking, facing Jake Rakes back in the first inning. That pitch right down the pipe evens the count at 1-1. Hawk to Diamond. 1-1 here kind of got away from Tanner Hawk. Patrick Cavanaugh doing a nice job to hop up there and make the grab, counting out 2-1 to Ben Diamond. That ball low. And count out 3-1. So the Mariners trying to work their way back into this game. They trail at 7-1. 3-1 pitch here is in there for a strike. We're now 4-3-2. Hawk to Diamond. The Mariners were threatening in the third inning as well. And the bases loaded with one out. And Evan Townsend hit into a double play to end the inning. 3-2 pitch here, and this one chopped to short, knocking it down and making the play. The shortstop, Carson Broadwater, on the little flip there to Tyler Hawk to record the out and get the lead runner. Goes as a fielder's choice, 6-4. Retiring the lead runner, Gayton Bercher, for the first down of the inning. Now Phillip Dennis coming to the plate. Dennis swings and misses the first pitch from Tanner Hawk. Dennis was one of six strikeout victims of Jake Rakus, went down to end the top half of the first inning. Swings and misses here at another pitch from Tanner Hawk. Now Ben Diamond on first and one out here in the top half of the fourth. The score is still 7-1, Yankees over the Mariners. That ball misses low and outside. Count now at 1-2. That ball line, but right at Carson Broadwater, who makes the grab for the second out of the inning. Broadwater thought that was it. I remember Gayton Bercher initially got on via an error. He was later retired on the fielder's choice that Diamond hit into. Now two outs with Dominic Borelli at the plate, who fouls off the first pitch from Tanner Hawk. Counted 0-1. 0-1 on the way, and this one golfed foul on the right side. Counted 0-2. Little League Field definitely not a good place to take a nap, though. Got to stay alert out there. Seen a couple foul ball screamers so far this evening. Now the 0-2 pitch. This one chopped foul on the far side. Count still at 0-2. The 0-2 pitch again. Swing and a miss. Strike three. So for Tanner Hawk, that's his second strikeout of the game. And the second time Dominic Borelli has been retired via the K. And the score remaining 7-1. Yankees over the Mariners here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Colon cancer is the second leading cause of cancer deaths. Signs include abdominal pain and rectal bleeding. Colon cancer develops from a degenerating benign growth or polyp. Doctors performing colonoscopy are able to remove precancerous polyps, thus preventing colon cancer. This saves lives, and the American Cancer Society now recommends that everyone have a colonoscopy every 10 years, beginning at age 50. Doctors Ruth Hart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou offer the latest diagnostic testing, SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
High energy costs eating away at your budget? Turn to the experts and call Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated at 724-438-5400 and ask for George or Mike. Let one of them tell you about Carrier's new green speed technology. Afraid of the cost of installing a geothermal system? Let Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated explain how green speed can help you achieve the same or similar results as geothermal without the same installation costs. Past history shows that the costs of heating and cooling your home are only going to continue to go up and up. Carrier's new green speed systems, when matched to your specific situation, will help you achieve substantial operational cost savings over conventional equipment. Green speed can give you the same or very similar results as geothermal in many different scenarios. Achieve SEER ratings of up to 20 with HSPF ratings of up to 12.5 for your home with green speed. Turn to the experts by calling Fayette Furnace Company at 724-438-5400 and asking for either George or Mike about giving you an estimate for combating the continuing high costs associated with heating and cooling your home.
Back here at the Beener Field in Hopwood, heading to the bottom half of the fourth inning. The Yankees leading the Mariners by a score of 7-1. Brian Morozek alongside Jerry Dupe. Brett Lemanski, Jake Rakus, and Patrick Cavanaugh do up here in the bottom half of the fourth inning, still facing Ben Diamond. Retired the Yankees 1-2-3 in the bottom half of the third inning. For Lemanski, this is his third plate appearance. He's 1-for-2 today. Had an infield single and scored a run in the first inning. And the first pitch here from Diamond in there for a strike to Brent Lemanski. Counted 0-1-1. Lemanski also flew out to then left fielder Nate Linderman back in the second inning. 0-1 pitch here from Diamond to Lemanski in there for another strike. And they counted 0-2. Now Lemanski must protect the plate. Diamond recorded two strikeouts back in the third inning. But Lemanski here with a little ground ball to short and making the play defensively. Gaten Bircher over to Evan Townsend to retire Lemanski 6-3 for the first out of this bottom half of the fourth inning. Now Jake Rakus coming to the plate. Rakus also 1-for-2 so far today. Had a single to right field and picked up two RBIs along with scoring a run back in the first inning. And then grounded out 6-3 back in the second inning. First pitch here from Diamond, fouled off by Rakus. Counted 0-1. It's the first of two games being played tonight here in Hopwood. A midget league game between the Blue Jays and Yankees will follow. A 1 pitch on the way, and this one popped up into right field and will drop fair in front of Tyler Kalich. So Jake Rakus, his second hit of the evening, a single to right. And the Yankees in business with one out here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Now Patrick Cavanaugh coming to the plate. First pitch to Patrick, fouled off. Counted 0-1. Patrick's reached base twice so far today, walked and scored a run back in the first inning, was hit by a pitch, and scored a run in the second inning. Behind 0-1 here. Breaking ball, just missing low and inside. Count now even at 1-1. And Patrick sending that one foul into the fence. Count at 1-2.
Really lock your eyes on one and square it up.
Now the 1-2 pitch, just off the plate. Count now even at 2-2. Now Diamond's 2-2 here to Patrick Cavanaugh. Off the plate again, and we're full of 3-2.
Lock your eyes and square it up.
Jake Rakus on first and one out. Here in the bottom half of the fourth inning, and there's your ball four. So So Diamond walking Kavanaugh. Runners now on first and second for the Yankees with Tanner Houck coming to the plate. And Houck certainly a productive evening so far. The deep home run to left center field, a three-run shot back in the first inning. Picked up another pair of RBIs in the second inning on a single. It swings and misses of the first pitch here from Ben Diamond. So five RBIs so far for Tanner Houck. He's drove in five of the seven runs scored by the Yankees in this game. Now has two runners on here again, but he falls behind 0-2 now on the count against Ben Diamond. And a lot of times you get in a situation like this, if you're Tanner Houck, you've already picked up five RBIs, you kind of feel invincible and you want to swing at every pitch. Just has to hang in there a little bit and still protect the plate down 0-2 here against Ben Diamond, and that pitch off the plate.
Promise yourself you're going to lock your eyes and keep
count out 1-2. That 1-2 pitch on the way and again off the plate. Count now even at 2-2. That one chopped to third, knocked down by Phillip Dennis. Tries to make the throw back to Gayton Bircher covering. But safe at third is Jake Rakus. And on the well-hit ball, we'll give Tanner Houck another hit. That'll load up the bases for Paxton Petronas. Petronas struck out looking back in the first inning, walked in the second inning. This is third plate appearance of the game. And comes up here in a big spot with the bases loaded and one out here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. First pitch from Diamond in there for a strike. Counted 0-1. Now Diamond's 0-1 here to Petronas. High and outside, evens the count at 1-1. We have to pass along a hello to our good friend John Kazarek. Hope he's doing well tonight. Watching our broadcast at home. 1-1 pitch in there for a strike. Count at 1-2. Certainly missed John out at the ball fields and the games. 1-2 pitch. Is high, evens the count at 2-2.
This is anywhere close, take the bat to it, Pax. Anywhere close.
There's ball three. Full count now, Diamond to Petronas, one out. Here in the bottom half of the fourth inning, still a 7-1 lead for the Yankees, but they really have an opportunity here to open up this game. Payoff pitch to Petronas, swing and a miss, strike three. So Petronas goes down, and now two away in the inning with Mike Tippett coming to the plate. Tippett was hit by a pitch back in the first inning, struck out in the second inning. Diamond's first pitch here to Tippett, and there for a strike, counted 0-1.
Stay in there. Don't back out. Stay where you are and hit the ball.
Diamond's 0-1 to Tippett, low and outside.
You're backing up as soon as he throws it. Stay in.
Count now even at 1-1.
You got hit in the head once. What are you afraid of? Don't worry about it.
One one pitch, swing and a miss, strike two.
Hit that if your feet would have stayed in. Keep your feet where they are and swing.
1-2 now, Ben Diamond to Mike Tippett. As the Mariners trying to get out of a big jam here, the base is loaded. 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. So Diamond recording back-to-back strikeouts, retiring Petronas and Tippett to get out of the inning with the bases loaded, and the score remains 7-1. Yankees over the Mariners. We're heading to the top half of the fifth here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
High energy costs eating away at your budget? Turn to the experts and call Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated at 724-438-5400 and ask for George or Mike. Let one of them tell you about Carrier's new green speed technology. Afraid of the cost of installing a geothermal system? Let Fayette Furnace Company Incorporated explain how green speed can help you achieve the same or similar results as geothermal without the same installation costs. Past history shows that the costs of heating and cooling your home are only going to continue to go up and up. Carrier's new green speed systems, when matched to your specific situation, will help you achieve substantial operational cost savings over conventional equipment. Green speed can give you the same or very similar results as geothermal in many different scenarios. Achieve SEER ratings of up to 20 with HSPF ratings of up to 12.5 for your home with green speed. Turn to the experts by calling Fayette Furnace Company at 724-438-5400 and asking for either George or Mike about giving you an estimate for combating the continuing high costs associated with heating and cooling your home.
Still 7-1 Yankees over the Mariners, heading to the top half of the fifth inning. Tyler Kalich, Logan Miller, and Sam Scala do up here for the Mariners. Kalich, who started the game in left field today for the Mariners, has moved around the outfield a number of times, struck out swinging back in the second inning. And also have a new pitcher here for the Yankees as well. It's number 10, Carson Broadwater. The third pitcher we've seen of the afternoon. And Tyler Kalich trying to get this inning going here for the Mariners. Count at 1-2. And Broadwater looking to make an immediate impact. And does just that, striking out Kalich to start this top half of the fifth inning. Now Logan Miller coming to the plate. Miller was another strikeout victim of Jake Rakes back in the second inning. Takes ball one here from Carson Broadwater. And the Mariners are loosening up. Looks like Alex Busby down the left field line. He might be their new pitcher in the bottom half of the fifth inning as Miller swings and misses at that pitch from Carson Broadwater. Count even at 1-1. Swing and a miss there. Count at 1-2. And the 1-2 on the way. Breaking ball just misses low and inside. Count it 2-2. Go, 2-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. Broadwater really bringing the heat there. And just like that, two away. Here in the top half of the fifth. Now Sam Scala coming to the plate. Sam takes the first pitch low for ball one. It's Carson Broadwater. Looks like we will see Alex Busby on the mound when we head to the bottom half of the fifth inning for the Mariners. Another pitch in there for a strike from Broadwater. Count even at 1-1, Broadwater to Scala. This one popped up in foul territory on the right side and out of play. Count now 1-2. And Broadwater now just a pitch away from striking out the side. They're trying to retrieve a baseball. Had a lot of foul balls here over the last couple of minutes. And they need to find one from somewhere. 5-1 for Carson Broadwater. If Broadwater can find the strike zone here to Sam Scala, he'll strike out the side. There's a breaking ball, and it's chopped here to short, and the play made over to first for the out, 6-3. So a 1-2-3, top half of the fifth inning. We'll head to the bottom half of the fifth inning with the score still 7-1, Yankees over the Mariners here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Southwestern Endoscopy Center is a state-licensed and Medicare-certified facility and emphasizes privacy, comfort, caring, and safety for colonoscopies and upper GI endoscopies. Painless procedures are done with twilight sedation given by a board-certified anesthesiologist. The center accepts most insurance plans and is staffed by Drs. Ruthart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind, we're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Heading to the bottom half of the fifth inning. A score remaining 7-1, the Yankees over the Mariners. We had 7 runs scored through 2 innings, but the last 2.5 have not had a run scored on either side. Been a little bit of a defensive struggle as of late. The Yankees still cruising up 6. Now have Blake Bell, Tyler Hawk, and Carson Broadwater coming to the plate here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. Facing a new pitcher in Alex Busby, who was catching for the first 4 innings of this game for the Mariners. He's now on the mound, and the first pitch here, a strike to Blake Bell as Bell swings and misses. Had a couple of other defensive changes on the Mariners side. We'll get to those in just a moment. Busby now a wind and fire the 0-1 here to Blake Bell. Swing and a miss. Now 2 strikes on Bell. Gayton Bercher is now catching. Ben Diamond playing first base. And Evan Townsend now playing shortstop for the Mariners. 0-2 pitch, low and outside. Count out 1-2, Busby to Bell.
Okay, Blake, side quick.
One, two on the way, and this ball sent just foul down the first baseline. Count remains 1-2, and again behind Bell will be the top of the order in Tyler Hawk and Carson Broadwater as the Yankees look for a couple of insurance runs. Yes, they're up 6, but never too comfortable of a lead here in the Little League games down in Hutchinson. Count out 2-2. There's ball 3, so now full of 3-2. Busby to Bell. Bell, the leadoff batter for the Yankees here in the bottom half of the fifth. 3-2 pitch. That's off the plate for ball 4. So Blake Bell reaches base for the second time in this game. Of course, he had a double to left center field back in the first inning. He's aboard on the top of the order coming to the plate, and Tyler Hawk. Hawk due for a hit. He's 0 for 3 today from the leadoff position. First pitch, Busby to Hawk outside for ball one. Tyler flew out to then first baseman Ben Diamond in the first inning in his first at-bat, then grounded out 4-3 to end the inning, struck out looking in the third inning. Certainly due. Takes a strike there. Count now even at 1-1. Busby's 1-1 here to Hawk. That pitch low, gets away from the catcher Bercher. Throw down to second. Wide of Townsend, who was covering the bag.
There he is, Tyler. Be big. Be big.
Count out 2-1. And Bell now at second base. Busby long looking, now set to go. That pitch misses outside. Now the 3-1. Ball fouled. Luckily there's a fence in front of me. Count now 4-3-2. This ball golfed into right field, and the catch made. That's Nate Linderman. No, Chris Powowar out there in right. Powowar number 4, making that grab, doing a nice job out there in right. That's the first out. In this bottom half of the fifth. That pitch a ball to Carson Broadwater. Blake Bell on second. Still one out. Here in the bottom half of the fifth. And the score is 7-1. The Yankees over the Mariners. That ball hit to third. Phillip Dennis long throw over to first. And they're going to rule it safe. Infield single. Nice hustle out of Broadwater. Now runners on first and second for Brett Lemanski. Lemanski 1-for-3 today. His lone hit an infield single in the first inning. He ended up scoring a run. Low ball there. And a little miscommunication here on the base paths for the Yankees. A throw not made there from Phil Dennis over to first. They could have had Broadwater off the bag. Broadwater on his way down to second, but the lead runner, Blake Bell, kind of held up a little bit, so Broadwater had to go back to first. Next pitch to Lemanski is low. Count now at 2-0. Now Lemanski back in the box. Next pitch high and outside.
Brett, you're green if you really love it. It's perfect. Oh my gosh,
it's still open. Now Busby needs to find the strike zone. That's ball four to Brett Lemanski. That'll load up the bases. With Jake Rakes coming to the plate. Rakes 2-for-3 today. Has a pair of RBIs and has scored a run.
Ball swing zone, no strikes.
Lead at 7-1. Yankees trying to blow this game open. Here in the bottom half of the fifth. First pitch to Rakes outside for ball one. Nowhere to put Rakes if you're Alex Busby. 1-0 pitch, and this ball roped to left and off the glove of the left fielder, Dominic Borelli. Two runs will score, and the lead now at 9-1. Blake Bell and Carson Broadwater scoring on the rakish hits. Brent Lemanski now at second, Rakus at first, and Patrick Kavanaugh coming to the plate. And Kavanaugh swings at the first pitch, and that ball threw right up the middle in a center field. Rounding third and on his way to the plate is Brent Lemanski. So an RBI single to center for Patrick Kavanaugh. Run scored for Lemanski, now three across here in the bottom half of the fifth. And the lead at 10-1. There's a 12-run mercy rule that would end this game if the lead is extended to 13-1. Here in the bottom half of the fifth inning, Tanner Hawk has picked up five RBIs already in this game. He's 3-for-3. Had a home run to left center field back in the first inning. Behind 0-1 here. And another pitch ruled a strike from Alex Busby, counted 0-2. So now Hawk must protect the plate. He's the seventh Yankee to bat here in the inning. We'll foul that one off to stay alive.
Quiet that head down. Keep it still.
Now the 0-2 again to Tanner Hawk. Now one high. Count at 1-2. And there's strike three. Nice pitching there from Alex Busby. Retired Tanner Hawk, who entered that at bat 3-for-3. Now Paxton Petronas will come to the plate. Now two outs here in the inning. Three runs already across. Busby trying to get his team to the top half of the sixth. And that pitch getting away from catcher Gayton Bircher. Runners advancing. Kavanaugh down to second. Rakus down to third.
Back to
1-0 pitch. Misses low, count out 2-0. There's a strike from Busby. Count it 2-1. Mentioned earlier, but worth mentioning again if you're watching on Atlantic Broadband or Armstrong Cable. Reminder that all of our broadcasts now available on YouTube. Let's go to YouTube.com and search South Union Television. Watch on demand anytime. As Petronas takes another strike.
Take the bat to this one. Calm, confident, hit the ball.
Two-two, low and outside. So go full of 3-2. Busby to Petronas. Three-two pitch, and Paxton stays alive, sending it foul on the left side.
Don't make it harder than that. Just take the bat to him. Let's do this. Do this. Take the bat to
it. So 3-2 again. Pitch on the way. Just tipped foul by Petronas.
got a good at bat going. I'll win the fight. It looks like a strike, get the bat on.
Patronus, the eighth Yankee to bat here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. The Yankees sent 10 men to the plate, scoring 5 runs in the first inning. And there's ball 4. That'll load the bases up again for the Yankees for Mike Tippett. Tippett was hit by a pitch back in the first inning, struck out in both the second and fourth innings. Try to come through here with the bases loaded. Tippett swings and misses the first pitch. It hops away from the catcher, Bercher. Bercher able to regain. No damage done. Count, though, at 0-1.
Get aggressive, Mike. Get aggressive. Don't go away from the ball.
Tippett focused at the plate. Takes a pitch low there for a ball from Alex Busby. Evens the count at 1-1. Another pitch in there for a strike. Nice breaking ball there from Busby. Count at 1-2 to Mike Tippett. One-two pitch, swing and a miss, strike 3. So the Yankees send 9 men to the plate. Pick up 3 runs here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. It's now a 10-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. The Mariners down to their final 3 outs as we head to the top half of the sixth here on the South Union Township Sports Network. The Mariners down to their final 3 outs. It'll be Nate Linderman, Chris Pawowar, and Alex Busby coming to the plate. A 10-1 lead for the Yankees over the Mariners. HARC Little League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupay. Nate Linderman will lead things off. Linderman batting from the number 10 position in the Mariners batting lineup, but Linderman did pick up a single and stole a base back in the third inning, trying to keep it going here, but he swings and misses at the first pitch from Broadwater. Now Broadwater's 0-1. Right down the pipe again, counted 0-2. Broadwater very effective in his first inning of relief in the top half of the fifth inning, where he struck out Tyler Kalich and Logan Miller before retiring Sam Scale on a ground ball, 6-3. 0-2 here to Linderman. That pitch didn't miss by much, but ruled low for ball 1. So the count now at 1-2. One, two, breaking ball, swing and a miss, strike 3. And it's Broadwater. mixing up the speed of the pitches, retires Linderman for the first outs. Now the top half of the sixth. Now Chris Pewowar at the plate. He takes strike one. Counted 0-1. Pewowar, like Linderman, had a single for the Mariners back in the third inning. Pewowar singling to center field. And now behind 0-2. Behind Pewowar will be the top of the order and Alex Busby. And Broadwater mowing him down right now. 0-2 pitch on the way, and there's your strike three. Back-to-back strikeouts. Broadwater retiring Linderman and Pewowar now two away with Alex Busby coming to the plate here in the top half of the sixth. Mariners down to their final outs. Busby's walked twice in this game and scored a run. Takes the first pitch here, a breaking ball from Broadwater for strike one. And the Mariners will need him to get aboard here if they want to extend this game. 0-1 pitch, another breaking ball, swing and a miss, strike two. Now the Yankees just a strike away. The 0-2, right down the middle for strike three, and the Yankees win 10-1 over the Mariners here at Hutchinson this evening. The Yankees picking up five runs in the bottom half of the first inning, two in the bottom half of the third, and adding three in the bottom half of the fifth. The Mariners picking up their lone run in the top half of the first inning. So a 10-1 win for the Yankees over the Mariners here in Hopwood tonight. Tonight's game was brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiff Bauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV, including Gary Smith. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay. Again, 10-1 your final. Yankees over the Mariners. This has been a South Union Township Sports Network presentation.